Hey, Art Family, if you like this one, there's a full-length version on Patreon.
They are skillful.
Hello, Art Family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. For this gouache demo, I wanted to do a classic VW bus that I pass by in my neighborhood when I'm walking my dog in the morning. I'm going to be using one of these multimedia paper sketchbooks. It's Strathmore 184, 186 pound mixed media paper. It's pretty cheap. You can buy it in pads, and I cut them in half and take them to the local print shop and have them bound into little booklets. I start the sketch out by doing a small thumbnail. I prefer to do a small thumbnail for most all of my sketches when I have the time to do it, unless I'm doing something on the fly or something on location where I either forget or don't have a lot of time. I like to take just a second and do a very small thumbnail sketch to get a sense of the value and the kind of composition and structure of a sketch before I go move to the final and commit to paint. The main goal, of course, being to try to break down the composition into simple shapes and then figure out the different pieces, how the pieces connect, and the most simplified values. So try to condense the range of values to just four values or three values if I can. The less the better, the more simple the better, and try to just get the statement down as simple as possible, and hopefully that will reflect in the final painting. So moving on to the sheet, I've taped off the edges just to get a nice clean edge when I'm done. And I like to kind of throw down a general wash of color. I kind of call it a cotton candy wash, which is, it's fairly arbitrary. I just sort of throw down some different colors that I'd like to have sort of shine through the final painting. But I'll use some of the primaries. And typically my concern is to just sort of have it shift slowly from warm to cool. In various areas, and then once that dries, I find gouache works best when it's sitting on top of other gouache. And then my preferred method for drawing, at least it has been lately, I'm sure you've noticed in earlier gouache videos, I used to draw with a pencil more, but I've kind of switched fairly recently to just using the brush directly and painting directly with the brush. I find it's still erasable, it's still just as erasable as pencil. It sort of feels like it skips a step or skips a tool in a sense. I can just move right to the paint. And I like the effect sometimes of when I'm putting the shapes together, especially something that has trees where there's green involved. You'll get this nice kind of, pink or red. I typically shoot for kind of a pinkish red, purpley sort of red. So the little edges where the shapes meet one another will have just this little hint of pink. It kind of gives this sort of vibration to the sketch, which I have come to really like. So my goal is to try to start putting these elements together and these shapes together and get them as close to the value as possible. And of course, value relationships are relative, and they change as you put down other objects. So as I go, it's going to change some of the relationships that I'm putting down now. But I'm just trying to put stuff down to give myself some kind of idea of what the values are going to be. At some point, I need to put down a darker value to kind of cast an anchor into the sort of depths of value and see how dark I can get it, and just how that will affect the relationship of these lights. Like, for example, the sky is a little bit too light, which you may not be able to tell yet. You can kind of tell if you look, looking back at this now, I can see it's a little too light. So I'm going to have to bring that down a little bit, because as light as it is now, it muddies up the relationship of the roofs to the front face of this roof and some of the other lighter objects. So in order to get a more clear and concise message here, I need to adjust that value just a little bit. I'm moving through and trying to be conscious of my light sources and the effects of light bouncing around. So we have light coming down and bouncing off of the concrete, which is going to create this warm shadow on the downward facing plane. So the soffit area, or the area where the roof kind of cantilevers out or juts out, that I'm putting paint on right now, is going to be warmer, stronger, kind of yellow ochre, because light's hitting that concrete, bouncing up into the lower areas. But those areas that are outward facing or upward facing are going to be cooler, because the atmospheric light, or the light from the blue sky, is going to fill up that with some blue light. So you're going to have a cooler shadow in those areas, picking up that atmosphere. I'm being kind of loose with this area. I'm keeping it kind of blue, perhaps a little bit too blue, which I adjust later on by darkening it. But I know that I need to keep this area very dark, because this is going to be a big dark element in this sketch. As you could tell from just looking at this photograph and also the value sketch I did earlier, this is where my kind of darker areas are going to be, which is what really attracted me to this van, other than that it's a kind of a cool van to see driving around the neighborhood from time to time, and then seeing it parked here, especially when it's parked here in this spot. I really like the way in the morning the light casts that strong shadow, so we get this really dark area behind the white of the van. So you get a really strong sense of light against dark with this car, inorganic shape or object. So you're getting a very kind of harsh edge. So you have this strong light and dark contrast, which already gives appeal to something. If you want something in your sketch to have appeal, you want to look for things that have like a nice strong light, dark relationship, because the strength of those of that contrast adds interest to the area object of interest in your sketch that you're trying to draw focus to. And conversely, everywhere else it helps to sort of knock back that relationship, to reduce the harshness of the lights and the darks, to sort of muddy those areas, because it reduces the interest in that information and draws focus to the area of harder contrast of light and dark, as well as edges. You can increase the sharpness of the edges in an area of interest to draw focus to that area and bring the viewer sort of into the sketch, where you can reduce the strength of those edges or soften those edges up outside of the area of interest to sort of push those things away. When I put in the blue shadow, I tried to carry that light blue around to some other areas where blue was picking up in the windows, but I did want to make a note talking about this sketch that when you're putting in windows in buildings or cars, typically they're not blue. It's sort of a rookie mistake to go real blue with the windows. I think people think, well, you know, the sky is reflected in the glass and so you get more cool light in the windows, but typically you get more warm on the inside because you see through it to the inside, and you get more of a sense of space, that there's a space that you're looking into when you go warmer, more burnt umber, more burnt sienna in the shadows of the inside of a window. And then occasionally, be sure you're observing it. And in this case, the back window of the van and some of the windows were picking up some of the atmospheric light, so I put those windows in. But you'll notice the inside, the rest of the windows on the van are warmer because it's picking up the light that's bouncing around on the inside and creating that kind of space. At this point, I'm trying to fine-tune my value relationships to push the darks where I need it to be darker, and to try to add this lighter side of the tree. I kind of wish that I had done this part. I sort of moved around before I went back to add the light side of the tree, and I kind of wish I had done that while the dark was still wet, so you could get that sort of chalky, gouache blur effect, which I tried to sort of duplicate by coming back with the darks, but it doesn't quite have that freshness that I wanted it to have in the tree. As in most of my gouache sketches, I'm using a 1-inch flat. It looks smaller in this one because this pad is much larger than I usually work. I'm usually working on postcard-sized crescent 100 illustration board, but this sketchbook is fairly large compared to what I usually work on. So here you can see the final sketch next to the value study thumbnail. I always try to do a thumbnail when I have time. I find it makes for a much better sketch, a much more comprehensive, readable sketch. It's very handy. So that's going to be it for this classic Volkswagen van. I hope you got a lot out of it. Of course, I'm always here to talk shop or for encouragement. And I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.